I don't want to be involved in drugs.
Yeah.
But I don't want to be sober either.
Yeah.
I never want to be sober because it would make my battle, my inner battle, too rough.
Yeah.
I know my limits with cocaine. I know my limits with pills. I know my limits with alcohol. I've known my limits when I was 25. Anything I did after 25, I did because I wanted to, but I knew my limits.
Right.
You know, when I got locked up, I couldn't imagine a world where I couldn't smoke pot.
Wow. You couldn't imagine that.
I couldn't imagine, okay, cocaine. I understand not having a girlfriend. I understand being broke. But I never understood a world where I did not smoke weed.
Huh.
When I was 25 years old, weed controlled my mood.
What did it do for you, you think?
I was in so much pain when I woke up. And I didn't know that then. You never know it when you're going through.
Yeah, yeah, you don't know. Especially at that age.
It takes 20 years to look back.
Yeah.
You know, I was thinking about it tonight how I was taking a shower. That if I quit comedy tomorrow, it would be to sign back up in college and take a psychology class to become a psychiatrist and do whatever I had to take. I'd probably be 65. But at 65, I would help so many people so deeper.
Yeah.
Because I went through it.
Yeah.
This is not somebody who studied it. I went through it, wrote about it, looked at it.
Mm-hmm.
I think about it. I think about what made you. I broke it down from the macro to the micro.
Well, you could put yourself in there. You could put them in your shoes and vice versa.
When you become a comedian,
yeah,
if you're not brutally honest with yourself, it's not going to end well.
Wow.
And in life in general,
yeah,
forget about comedy, in life in general, if you're not brutally honest with yourself, it's not going to pan out for you.
Yeah.
You have to be brutally honest, and a lot of people can't be honest. Brutally honest with yourself. Like, this is not going to work. You know, it's like I went at 27, 29.
Like, in what fact? Like,
at the age of 30,
yeah,
I had made a decision, decision to do comedy.
Yeah.
But I also had to make a decision about this hell I was living in. I was living in this party hell. Okay.
The drugs and this
stuff. Where I would be clean for 3 days.
Oh, yeah.
And then snap one night and then tell myself how this was the last time.
Yeah.
I wasn't one of those pussies at a party that was talking about it. And by this time, I was partying by myself. And this went on for maybe a year and a half.
Yeah.
And I think by 1995 and a half, I came to the conclusion, like they say in the program, mm-hmm. that you're a fucking junkie.
Yeah.
And I had two decisions to make. I go, I could either be a junkie and keep fighting this, but the reason why I became a comic was to be a junkie. I read that Lenny Bruce book, and that's the reason why I got into comedy. So if I'm going to get into comedy, let's make a deal. I'll do cocaine 3 times a week.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how it started. I just came to terms with it.
Wow. So you're thinking I'm going to get into comedy so I could do cocaine.
I was thinking I was going to get into comedy to have a life. I read that book, how he slept with strippers.
And yeah.
He opened up jazz musicians. And I was content with that. And yeah. None of that book did he talk about being rich.
Yeah.
Okay? And no part of that book did he talk about being rich. Did he talk about money? He lived at the Chelsea Hotel. He just talked a life about being what was happy for him.
Yeah.
And at that time, that's all I wanted. I had been through a terrible marriage. I had already done time, so I was just seeking to be happy, but I knew I had to mend inside.
Because you had a deviant soul. Your soul was pretty sound, like kind of bifurcated or whatever.
I was living, you know, this wasn't who I was. I was a nice Catholic boy who I believed in heaven and hell, and I had a belief system.
Your inside didn't match all your behaviors.
Right. My inside did not, so that added to it.
Yeah.
So now, man, I had to have that inner conflict with drugs. Fuck you. This is who I am. I've accepted it.
Yeah.
And whatever happens, happens. That's it. No fucking big deal. Nobody gets their feelings.
You hunting Easter eggs again, Lee? Oh, you found one, huh? You found an egg, boy. Welcome to Easter, bro. Y'all killed Jesus. Here he comes back, boy.
This is good.
And he brought a dirty bag of fucking baked ham out of the fucking cave.
This smells worse than your neck. This smells like those Hondurans' feet that are walking in.
Oh, yeah, boy. It smells like fucking Thanksgiving night in a prison shower. Can you imagine those
take their shoes off at night and sleep under a tree?
I can't even imagine.
What that little summer camp must smell like down there. They've been walking for 20 fucking days, those poor people.
Oh, Hondurans will walk 30 hours in a 24-hour day. 20
fucking days, and they're really coming.
What are they going to do up here, do you think?
I think they're trying to seek asylum. You know, living in Honduras or Salvador right now, those are not good places to live right
now. Makes me sad, man. Yeah, my father's from Nicaragua. You know that my father was born down there.
If you know anything about Central America, I know like El Salvador is, the prices are high. They're killing people down there.
10th Planet Kush, it drains the lactic motherfucking acid. People won't cop to it. The health specialists say, no, that doesn't happen, Joey. Yes, it fucking does. I got friends at Harvard, bitch. I'm like Garth Brooks. I got friends in high places, motherfuckers.